Hello, so in today's class, we will look into the next application of generalized principle of inclusion and exclusion. So that is used in the concept of derangements and how to find the number of different derangements. So in today's class, we'll define what is called a derangement and we will look at its generalization and we'll find an expression for the number of derangements using the generalized principle of inclusion and exclusion. So, let us first of all define what is called a derangement. Okay. Now, suppose you are given the n elements a1, a2, etc., an, and namukku idinte permutations edukkanam. So, there will be n places. So, you have position 1, position 2, etc. Position n. So we will be arranging these objects into these positions. ഇനി നമ്മൾ എടുക്കുന്ന permutation ല് A1 എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് അതായത് നമ്മുടെ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് ഫസ്റ്റ് പൊസിഷനിൽ വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ സോ വി കോൾ ദാറ്റ് ടു ബി എ ഫിക്സഡ് പോയിന്റ്. സോ ഇഫ് എനി AI ഈസ് ഇൻ ദി ith പൊസിഷൻ. സോ നമ്മൾ എടുക്കുന്ന ith ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് ith പൊസിഷനിൽ തന്നെയാണ് നമ്മൾ പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ എടുക്കുകയും വരുന്നെങ്കിൽ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് കോൾഡ് ആസ് എ ഫിക്സ് പോയിന്റ്. നൗ ബൈ ഡീറേഞ്ച്മെന്റ് വി മീൻ സോ നൺ ഓഫ് ദി ഒബ്ജക്ട്സ് ആർ ഇൻ ദി കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് പൊസിഷൻസ്. അതായത് ith ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് ഒരിക്കലും ith പൊസിഷനിൽ വരാൻ പാടില്ല. സോ നോ എലമെന്റ് അപ്പിയേഴ്സ് ഇൻ ഇറ്റ്സ് ഒറിജിനൽ പൊസിഷൻ. സോ വെൻ യു സേ ദാറ്റ് the permutation it's deranged when none of the AIs occupy the ith position. So if they occupy the ith position, so they are called as a they are called as fixed points. Okay, so derangement is a permutation of the elements of a set such that no element appears in its original position in other words a derangement is a permutation that has no fixed points. So that is the definition of a derangement. Now we will look at how to find the number of permutations of n objects such that there are k fixed points. അപ്പോൾ ഞാൻ പറയുകയാണ് ഞാൻ കുറെ ഒബ്ജക്ട്സിനെ പെർമ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നു n ഒബ്ജക്ട്സിനെ പെർമ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നു. അപ്പൊ ആ പെർമ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ സോ പ്രൊവൈഡഡ് ദർ ആർ കെ ഫിക്സ് പോയിന്റ്സ് ഹൗ മെനി സച്ച് പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻസ് ആർ ദർ. സോ ലെറ്റ് അസ് ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദ വാല്യൂ ഓഫ് സച്ച് പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻസ്. സോ we will use the generalized principle of inclusion and exclusion for that. So before moving into the theorem, so let us give few more notations also. Okay, we denote dn as the number of derangements as the number of derangements of nn so nn here that will be the set a1 a2 etc. a1 will be the set of n elements Now for 1 less than or equal to r less than or equal to n, an r permutation of nn is an arrangement of r elements of nn in a row. So that's how we define an R permutation. So we need to choose R objects out of N and then arrange them in a row. Now, an R permutation. So let us take the R permutation to be A1, A2, etc. AR of NN is said to have a fixed point I, where I equal to 1, 2, etc. R if AI is equal to I. And for 0 less than or equal to K less than or equal to R, let, so we use the notation D of N, R, K denote the, so this denote the number of R permutations of NN that has exactly K fixed points. So you have total n objects. Now I'm permuting r objects at a time, and k is the number of fixed point it has. The number of fixed points on the 0 hour, 1 hour, 2 hour, maximum r vare. Okay, so let d of nrk denote the number of r permutations of nn that have exactly k fixed points. So therefore dn will be, ini dn nu arena that is number of derangements. From derangement nu arena none of the points occupy the original position. So the number of fixed points will be equal to 0. So therefore, by using this notation, dn will be d of, so there will be total n objects, we will be taking n permutation, and there will be no fixed points. So dn will be d of nn 0. Now, we are interested in finding d of nrk. So let us find the value of d of n rk using generalized principle of inclusion and exclusion. So we will state a satyaram. So we are going to find a series expansion for d of n rk. Now the theorem states that for integers n rk such that n greater than or equal to r greater than or equal to k greater than or equal to 0 and r greater than or equal to 1, d of nrk is given by rck by n minus r factorial into summation I equal to 0 to r minus k minus 1 whole power I r minus k I n minus k minus I factor. So that's the expression for d of n rk. Now for using the generalized principle of inclusion and exclusion, so we need to define our universal set and the properties on the universal set. Okay. So let us define S as the set of all R permutations of N. So let S be the set of R permutations of NN, and let us define R properties for the elements S. ഇനി നമ്മൾ പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി ഡിഫൈൻ ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നത് ഇങ്ങനെയാണ്. So an element or a permutation belonging to S is said to satisfy the property P1 if A1 is equal to 1. That is, first position we have a fixed point will satisfy the property P1. Then P2 if the second point is a fixed point. Then P3 if the third point is a fixed point. So those are our that is our universal set and the properties. So we define R properties on S as follows. So an element A1, A2, etc. AR in S is said to possess property PI if and only if AI is equal to I, where I is equal to 1, 2, etc. R. So if in the ith position you have AI, then that particular permutation is said to satisfy the property PI. So therefore, D of nrk, now by D of nrk we mean that is a number of permutations with k fixed points. So that is the number of elements which satisfy k properties at a time. So therefore D of nrk will be equal to E of k. And now let us look at what is the value of omega of namukku ini kandupidikkanda omega of 1, omega of 2, extra omega of r vare namukku kandupidikkanam. So now let us look at what is the general value of an omega of t. Now let us consider a t such that 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to r. Now let us look at what is the value of omega of p1, p2, etc. pt. P1, p2, pt edukkumbo. So it satisfies. So there are total r positions. Ini r positions la t positions la namakku fixed aanu. Appo t positions naan already so out of n objects you are choosing r objects at a time. Appo r objects la t objects exactly t places la aadyam place cheyidu. Now remaining there will be r minus t objects. So that r minus t objects will be chosen from n minus t objects. So we will choose the r minus t objects, so that can be done in n minus t c r minus t ways. Now the r minus t objects can be arranged among themselves in r minus t factorial ways. So therefore omega of p1 p2 pt. Appo nammal total r objects edukkund r objects le t objects nu parayna nammal fixed aaki vekkum adinna position already specified aanu. Appo adu nammada arrangements le varunnilla. So baaki r minus t objects they can be arranged among themselves. So this can be, so omega p1 p2 pt will be equal to n minus t c r minus t into r minus t factorial ways. So but r minus t factorial cancel out, so you will get n minus t factorial by n minus r factorial. Okay, so that will be omega of p1 p2 etc.